Hey, this is Ralph. In this video, I want to determine with Excel how much house we can afford to get based on a few inputs like household income. So I had a student ask me about this earlier today, and they were wondering, could we use Excel for this? And I said, yeah, we can. And we'll use some stuff that we know how to do, like payment functions, but we'll kind of go in a reverse method and use the PV function. First, let's make some nice little areas for input. I want to make my column A a bit wider here. And we'll say, what is our monthly household income? Okay, and for now, I'll just go ahead and put in a figure. And let's say maybe our monthly household income is going to be 8,000. And let's go ahead and make that into a currency. We'll get rid of the decimals. There we go. So this would be a place where you could input some new numbers. Great. Now, let's go by the rule of thumb that our mortgage payment, our rent, whatever, our housing payment shouldn't be more than 25%. So we'll go ahead and put in our ideal monthly mortgage payment. And that's simply going to be equal to our monthly take-home pay. And we could have, say, we could multiply this by 0.25. We just want to get 1/4 of it. So 2,000, and I'm going to use my format painter to copy that formatting over. Let's also factor this in. How much down payment do we have? And maybe we have 35,000 saved up, and let's format that. There we go, and bring that over. So now we have some key input information. Let's go ahead and off to the side, make what looks like a standard mortgage payment calculator. So we're gonna have our house price, our down payment. That's going to lead to the loan amount, of course. We need to know what the interest rate for this mortgage is going to be. And let's see. We have to know the number of years, months. So number of years. And then we're going to have our monthly payment right there. Now, some pieces of information we'll plug in over here, like the interest rate. Let's assume our interest rate is going to be 3.2%. There we go. Number of years, let's go ahead and do this as a 15-year mortgage. That would be ideal if we can get a 15-year mortgage based on our data here. Now for our monthly payment, I'm gonna rig this so that it is equal to our ideal monthly payment from over there on the left. Okay, we've got that taken care of. And let's see, we can also do something similar for down payment. Our down payment can be equal to how much down payment do we have. Now for loan amount, we're going to calculate the loan amount using the PV function, present value function. So equals PV for present value, parentheses. I'm going to click on the cell that contains my loan interest rate, divide it by 12 to get a monthly rate, comma. Then I'm going to click on the cell that contains the number of years, 15, multiply that by 12 to get the number of months within 15 years, comma. And then for the payment argument, we're going to do a minus sign and click on the cell that contains our monthly payment there. I'm going to closing parentheses. That's my present value. So basically with my data as it is, we're looking at a loan of $285,000. Now, of course, if our down payment is $35,000, that means our house price is going to be equivalent to down payment plus loan amount. Therefore, if we have an $8,000 per month take-home income, if we want our ideal mortgage payment to be $2,000 a month, or no more than that certainly, and we have $35,000 for a down payment, then that means we can look at a house that is around $320,000. That'll get us to our goal of that $2,000 a month monthly payment. Now, to see if this really works, we want to change some of the arguments around. Well, what if our monthly household income is actually $6,700? Well, that's certainly going to reduce our ideal monthly payment, and that shows up here, which is going to reduce our loan amount, and even with that same down payment, is going to reduce the house price that we can look for. So, what we've got going on basically, the real key to this working, is that present value function to determine the loan amount. If we have a smaller down payment, then that means less house. If we have a lot of down payment, then that means more house. And obviously, if we have more take-home monthly pay, that means more house. Now, Do you want to be a little bit more risky? What if it wasn't 25% of your take-home pay? What if it was up to 30% of your take-home pay? That increases your monthly payment allotment, which could potentially increase the price of the house you're looking for. However, if you keep yourself at that 15-year fixed mortgage and keep it as close as you can to 25%, maybe set a hard rule that you're not going to go over 30. Don't forget, there could be some other expenses to go along with this, like property taxes, mortgage insurance, depending, and stuff like that. But now you can use this calculator to help determine how much house you can afford in your market based on your income level. Thanks for hanging out with me.